Yo, what's going on, guys? Chris Bond here, Overtime Athletes. A little bit different video for you guys today. Recently, I got a question or comment that was a question in the comments. Essentially, it was somebody who asked, you know, what it is I did to study. What was my path of study? Or what books did I study? It was something like that. I was trying to find it. But anyway, I noticed the question had like 50 likes. I don't think I've ever got a comment that had 50 likes. So I figured I'd address this because if there's 50 of you out there that want to know, you know, there's some coaches on this channel. It's a pretty good mix. So I want to just kind of give you guys an insight as to maybe give you guys some resources of what I've studied. So first and foremost, let you guys know, if you don't know, I went pre-med at the University of Miami in their Applied Kinesiology and Physiology program, basically exercise physiology. But I never obviously went to med school. You can see right there, Chris, you're gonna get a shot of it. So I went into the School of Education for that. Honestly, I just want to shout out to my professors because that gave me my base. Although I was already coaching people, I was already a personal trainer at LA Fitness before I even went to college. That was what gave me, kind of boosted me to the next level. Do I say everybody needs to go to college? No, but for me, it was really good for me to have that base. Dr. Wesley Smith, Dr. Perry, Dr. Signorelli, Dr. Biagioli, if there's anybody else, shout out to my organic chemistry. That was the worst class ever. And then my physics class, that was probably the close second worst class I've ever taken in my life. And yeah, they sucked really bad. But that gave me my base. And then after that, kind of continued education that could support you guys, I just wanted to go over a couple books. My professor actually, instead of going into the master's program, my final year, I ended up starting training with him in the morning. And when I trained with him in the morning, Brian Biagioli, he's actually the head of NCSF. I think he created it, which is the National Council on Strength and Fitness. I think he's an amazing resource. I was grateful enough blessed enough to be able to work alongside him or work out with him, and I just constantly picked his brain. Remember, this is something I absolutely love. I was trying to better myself as an athlete, as a football player, and then in return I was able to kind of help and coach guys, and I just consumed so much from him. He went on to write a book, which I think is one of the best. This is like, for me, this is everything. Advanced Concepts of Strength and Conditioning. This is a book that I constantly refer to. If you watch any of my videos, you might even see a lot of the stuff of where I pull the ideas from. This is a huge resource. I suggest all of you guys. I wish I could put a link to it down below. Maybe I can, but that's from my professor. Another book that I came across through training, I've told you guys about this one. This is Triphasic Training. I'm sure I've sent a lot of people to him, and I'll constantly continue to plug him. Cal Dietz, amazing resource. This is what supported me in reaching, this game kind of gave me a game plan or strategy to develop my vertical jump, and it's been a basis of what I've been able to utilize in strength and conditioning. A final one that I read while I was in college that had some really great resources that's a little bit older is Super Training by Mel Siff. I think it's a good one, but I think it's a little bit advanced for some of you guys who are just getting into it. Another book that's really good is by, not this one, Serious Strength Training, but this author in particular, Tudor Bompa, is really good. He's got some really good content, and I suggest you guys utilize him as a resource. I think he's really good. But to be quite honest with you guys, I'd be lying if I didn't tell you where I pull a lot of that. So I mentioned my professors, and Dr. Signorelli and Dr. Wesley Smith, Dr. Biagioli, when I took their classes, I had a crazy amount of resources from taking their classes. So what you guys don't realize is, you know, when you do that at that level, you basically break down research. And my advanced nutrition class is what allowed me to start getting into research, actual research papers. and like kind of diving into how they do them. Now, this is why I always say I'm evidence-led and not based, because honestly, once you start to break down research, you quickly realize that how that research is developed, who's developing it, and who's supplying or financing the research is usually what you're gonna get as a result. For instance, I remember we went over this, what we call Noakes versus Gatorade. Noakes was a exercise physiologist in South Africa, and he basically went against Gatorade and saying how it was all about, you know, water was just as sufficient as Gatorade. Well, come to find out, a lot of those research papers that were coming out supporting Gatorade, saying they were better than water, were from actually financed by the company Gatorade. So obviously, if a company's paying for the research study to be done and conducted, you know they're gonna try to look for a particular outcome. Not just that, if you're anybody who's, we have a new coach here who worked at the University of Tampa, and they do a lot of studying as well. You start to realize that the results and the people who are being conducted on typically are, you know, it can sometimes be bullshit. Obviously, we're utilizing this and we can then get to draw some conclusions and get some good evidence. But that's what a lot of schooling taught me in breaking down research papers. And I had a fortune enough to take a class, and literally for 2 years we went basically on everything from neuromuscular training, resistance training, lifting for weight loss, muscular fiber types in training, super slow training. I mean, I have so many different packets that basically are just essentially research paper after research paper. I don't know if you can see this, of just breaking down results. And when I had to go through schooling on this, you know, all we did was break down research papers. Now, that's why I say that's what my backing is. Because to be honest with you, anytime I have a particular question, I go to this and I say to this, hey, based on my experience, based on the evidence here, you know, what can I conclude and what can I start to implement with my athletes? So I just gotta be honest with exactly how I kind of approach things. I'm constantly utilizing these as resources. I've kept all my notes from college because Miami was expensive as shit, and I come from a blue collar ass family, and yeah, it cost me a lot of money, so I figured I might as well keep it and save it and utilize it. Yeah, and that's what it is. Other than that, there's some guys as far as Ralph Mann that I study, Lawrence Seagraves that I study for speed. And beyond that, I'm constantly trying to put myself in front of new ideas. I still watch YouTube videos and learn from other guys because of my base level of knowledge and experience. And then I take from, nobody's beneath or above or below me. It could be a green kid fresh out of high school who can teach me something as far as being able to implement it as far as performance, or remind me. If you guys watch some of my old videos, I'm so technical, as if I'm trying to talk to academia and to coaches. And you know, sometimes I realized when I started working with athletes, I had to drop that lingo, I had to drop that verbiage and actually start to relate to them. Like I said early in the video, it's not sometimes what you coach, it's how you coach. So I had to get better at how I coached and conveyed my ideas. So I hope this helps some of you guys. I hope you guys are able to pull some resources from this, a couple names, a couple books for you to get. I'll let you guys next time.
Hey guys, thanks so much for watching. If you're interested in becoming a better athlete, whether that be sprinting, jumping, strength, or overall looking like an athlete, go ahead and click the box here on my side and make sure that you subscribe to my videos here so I can keep sending them to you. Holler.